Hey folks, Trace Monk here playing Life is Strange, Episode 1. And we're about to go meet Warren with his flash drive. Full of movies and other things that probably shouldn't be on a flash drive. We're just, you know, anyone's gonna see him. Uh oh.
That hurt! Damn, I better rewind.
This shit.
Ow! That hurt.
Oh wait. Is it possible for me to like stand in the way here?
Get lost, hipster. I'm not doing any fuck this shit.
Ow! That hurt.
Hey. I'm trying to figure out if this is like something where it's like
Alyssa, move your head.
Okay.
If you
there
insist,
we go.
Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
That action will have consequences.
Max, that was awesome. Thank you.
No problem. You have quick reflexes.
Years of mad dodging skills. Bullies never change.
That's why you're better off.
You're smart.
Seriously, the lip syncing. It would almost be better if their mouths didn't move.
Now I have to finish this stupid book.
Then you wouldn't necessarily know.
Get lost, hipster. I'm not doing any interviews.
Okay, asshole.
I always get a little giddy when I think about having my own room here.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
Intervene.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Uh-huh.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate.
Okay. So.
I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate, but now author David Dickhead is after me. Maybe I should rewind and mind my own business?
Let's see what happens here.
You can't fool me. I know everything about this school. I cover the waterfront. So you better figure out what side you're on.
Please, leave me alone. Hope you enjoyed the show. Thanks for nothing, Max.
Man, I should have stepped in between Kate and David. That asshole was so over the line. I could rewind and try something different.
Yeah, we'll rewind again. Come on. And we'll intervene. Skip through it.
Hey!
Rather be a good friend at this point. Slightly chuggy. What can I say? I'm only running this on an i5. So it is taking up a decent chunk of my CPU. Game actually has a pretty low memory profile though. Well, and my disk throughput isn't that hot some of the times.
I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied. I better go there soon to see if Joyce is still there. And get a burger. Good thing I don't have a car. Yet.
Cars equals death.
Who toilet papers a bike?
Seriously. Like, what's the point?
The whole town is turning into one giant missing persons poster.
Seriously, they are everywhere, and it's just the one person. It's not even like it's, you know, more and more people are disappearing.
Now this really pisses me off. So entitled. Sorry, handicapped folks. My truck needs these two spots more than you do. Bastard.
Oh, wait, who's over here?
I don't get it. How could Zack and Victoria do that to me?
Juliet still looks upset about Zack and Victoria. I don't blame her. Hi, Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zack yet?
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria as a joke. Ha ha. I think Warren wants your attention.
He usually does. Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
Oh. It's X-ing it out to make it like it should say retarded.
I wonder how long before Samuel has to repaint that.
Probably not very long.
Come on over here, please. What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978, to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Had I known that. Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
By the way, I saw Daniel's sketch of you online. Not bad, but I could do a much better job.
You can draw? I thought you were blinded by science, not art.
Art is science. Music is math, etc., etc. I'd put Stephen Hawking against Picasso any day.
Hardcore. So you must use a computer to draw?
Of course. I'd love to tweak one of your selfies with some cool graphics.
That might not suck. I'll let you know.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill kill.
Russ Meyer was a genius of black and white. Plus, babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of flipping fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caufield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal. Now. Answer me, bitch.
I told him the truth. A student had a gun.
No, you told him I had a gun. That's why he dragged me into his office.
And did what? Give you a stern lecture?
Nobody. Nobody lectures me. Everyone tries, though. They try.
You should talk to somebody, Nathan.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caufield.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh, man. You're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal, or that whore
right
in the bathroom!
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
Go! Go! I got this!
Get in, Max!
Okay.
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
Okay, that was weird.
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caufield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
No, it felt like a real city for artists. Big and bright. Great for taking pictures.
Yeah. Must be hard coming back to a hick town like Arcadia again.
Not after seeing you.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Of course. It's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Mark Jefferson.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher, not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I wanted to. I was just so tripped out over leaving Arcadia.
Oh, please. I'm sure your phone and laptop were frozen in time.
You're merciless.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Busted.
Man, are you serial?
Wow, haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it at my place.
I need very specific, tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage. And he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
Wow.
Come on in, don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home.
Oh, teenagers. I think I'd say that about this pair even if I was still a teenager myself.
Hey,
everybody
lies. My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-führer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
This postcard is from Rachel Amber. It won't play without any power.
Really? We're gonna have a puzzle to... Oh, okay, maybe not much of a puzzle, but, you know. A little bit of a puzzle-ish thing.
Now, let's see what kind of music Chloe is into these days.
Music.
I think this junk swallowed her discs.
Oh, she's
so it was Chloe who printed all those flyers. Who'd have thunk Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets? She does love trouble.
Yeah, like a... Oh. There's the actual original photo of Rachel, apparently.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot. Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened? Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her.
I believe you. I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. Then poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Okay, let's put this CD in, find out what it is.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
Okay. I was noticing this while we were in here before that, like, obviously, you know.
I shouldn't bug Chloe now. Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height. Goodbye,
my sad.
Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her.
You didn't even recognize her until you were, you know,
nothing but junk
being
in this
threatened
suitcase.
By Nathan.
She looks super happy.
Just pictures on that laptop, huh? Okay.
We had such a blast drawing these together. Out of Blackwell 2 years ago. She used to be a great student. When she cared. And it reeks like dirty laundry. Gross.
Okay, we'll leave the box alone, but we have the knowledge that... Chloe, started to fail classes and such.
Whoa, dark. I cannot see anything. I'm singing songs about the future. This is definitely Joyce's makeup. Chloe wouldn't use animal products. I hope Chloe isn't taking these pills.
Fluoxetine. That sounds familiar. Do I really wanna know? Yeah. You're making love now to the lady down the road. Antidepressant. Yeah, it's Prozac.
I like Chloe's new hair color. She's the opposite of shy. Of me.
Be funny if it was all like, there will be consequences of you not turning off the light.
You can't go home again, said Thomas Wolfe. But here I am. This must be Chloe's parents' room. Man, I am nosy today. Oh shit! Poor thing. I bet I could do something to save it.
Maybe.
Dog tags. Sweet. David Mattson.
Must be stepdad. There we go.
Act, React, or Die, a 21st century survival guide. Whoa, apocalypse. Oh my. Chloe made this for Joyce on Mother's Day years ago. I see why she would keep it. Joyce still works at the diner. Is her husband a cop? Poor Chloe. Uh-oh. The prices are late on their bills.
Ah.
Joyce looks happy. Chloe's stepdad might not be a douchebag after all.
You gotta look at that face. That looks like he's a scumbag security guard guy.
Joyce always loved her mail order catalogs of useless crap. Aww. Joyce has a little shrine to William. Her new husband may not be such a douche.
You're going off of very little evidence there, Max.
Oh shit! Poor thing. I bet I could do something to save it.
Oh, you know what? Now the bird is alive inside the room.
You've been resurrected, birdie. Fly, be free. Uh-oh. The prices are late on their bills.
I wonder why all those other little things were kind of saved as decisions there. Next time, Max goes downstairs to the garage where I guess we'll fix the camera? I don't know. I'll see you next time.